Experience Rome's best 360-degree rooftop view from the Victor Emmanuel Monument. And nearby, we'll visit the world's oldest shopping mall in Trajan's Markets. Our wonderful time in Rome continues as we enjoy its fabulous sights. We head over to Piazza Venezia to visit the rooftop terrace on the large Victor Emmanuel Monument. We first climb flights of stairs to a mid-level terrace, then walk around the back of the building to reach the elevator. The mid-level terrace also has a cafe on the other side with great views of Trajan's Market across the street. We then explore the ancient market, walking through its upper level. Accessing it was not obvious. Walk around this corner and continue up a flight of stairs. And this is the entry to the Museum of the Imperial Forum, as well as the markets. The Victor Emmanuel Monument, or just Vittoriano for short, is also known as the Altar of the Fatherland. An imposing structure, built in white marble with many stairs. It was inaugurated in 1911 as a tribute to the first king of Italy, Victor Emmanuel II, who unified the country in 1870. It also houses the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier and a reunification museum. And front and center is a large statue of the king mounted on his horse. His mustache is over 5 feet wide. We enter the building near ground level and climb about 5 flights of stairs to reach the mid-level terrace. Apparently, there is a private internal elevator, and if you ask the guards on the lower level, they may let you use it if you have mobility issues.
There is an elevator that takes us to the roof. That's our plan.
The elevator fee is currently 10 euros, but for us, the views from the top were worth the expense.
Yeah, see how they dug in the walls to put in the pipes and cables?
On each end sit statues of Goddess Victoria riding a four-horse chariot. Looking west, in the distance, we see the large dome of St. Peter's Basilica at the Vatican, and closer is the Dome of the Pantheon.
It's a bit of a close-up of the Pantheon. Coliseum. Good view from up here. Coliseum, Roman Forum, Palatine Hill.
In the back, you can see the largest standing Egyptian obelisk in the world, originally from the Karnak Temple near Luxor. It was brought to Rome in 357 AD. We head back down the elevator and walk to the east side by the mid-level terrace cafe. The road from Piazza Venezia to the Colosseum was completed by Mussolini in 1932. Imagine, before that, the Colosseum wasn't visible from Piazza Venezia. The road's construction demolished an entire neighborhood of medieval and Renaissance buildings, including homes and small churches, and revealed were old ruins of ancient imperial forums. The ruins of the Forum of Caesar could be seen from this vantage point. And across the road are remnants of the Forum of Trajan, including the buildings of Trajan's Market. Emperor Trajan ruled for 19 years until 117 AD. Declared best ruler by the Senate, he enlarged the empire's territory to its maximum size. He was very popular with the people, implementing multiple public building programs and social welfare policies. This is Trajan's Column, at the north end of what was Trajan's Forum. Completed in 113 AD, it has a fabulous bas-relief that runs down the column in a continual spiral. It depicts Trajan's war victories with over 2,600 figures in 155 scenes. A statue of Trajan once was on the top, and it disappeared in the Middle Ages. It was then capped with a statue of St. Peter in 1587. Trajan's Market is thought to be the world's oldest shopping mall, and it's also believed to have housed administrative offices and apartments. Vendors would set up shop in these little stalls. There were about 150 of them in the marketplace. If you enjoy my videos, I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified of new releases. It's free, and sharing with your friends is much appreciated.